I've recently reported on 12 crew members on board major cruise ships who were arrested at Port Miami for possession of abusive content on their cell phones, ranging from farm animals and adults and children and infants. It's just awful. And I've been asked frequently why so many of those who've been arrested are Filipino. And I'm not a psychiatrist. I'm a lawyer. But here's my analysis. Please don't be offended. And please tell me if you agree or don't agree and what your thoughts are. Number one, the majority of crew members on cruise ships are Filipino. So if you're going to arrest 12 crew members, the most likely the majority are going to be Filipino. Number two, until recently, the Philippines had one of the lowest ages of consent in the world. They recently changed it to 16, but it was very low for decades. And so culturally, perhaps seeing preteens engaged in sexual activity was something that some Filipinos were accustomed to seeing. I don't know. But if the age of consent is under 13 for decades and then becomes 16, there may be some cultural shift. Number three, during the pandemic, apparently the Philippines became sort of an epicenter for the production, distribution, and sale of this kind of abusive content. Apparently, the financial situation in that country for some folks, and there's a particular area of the Philippines where apparently it is the Hollywood, if you will, of where this kind of material is being produced. Parents in desperate financial situations were creating content with their children or for their children or with their children and then selling it as a means of income. Awful as that may seem. Number three is that I don't believe that the cruise lines are informing the crew members about the consequences of having this stuff on their cell phones when they come to port at the U.S. I think that the crew members are probably caught by surprise. And I think that the cruise lines need to inform the crew members, look, first of all, we don't want you to have this stuff on your phones, period. But if you insist on having it and you get inspected by Customs and Border Patrol in the U.S., you're going to jail and you're going to go to jail for a long time. I don't think the crew members know the law in the U.S. They don't know that Customs and Border Patrol can come and inspect their phones. They don't come from that environment. And so they're caught by surprise. Additionally, these cruise ships are larger and larger and require more and more crew members. And the net is being thrown out a lot wider than it has been in before. And the cruise lines may be desperate to hire these underpaid and overworked individuals. And as a result, some super creeps are being caught up in the net and they're not being vetted appropriately. And the cruise lines need to initiate in their hiring protocols and procedures some kind of psychiatric evaluation to make sure they're not hiring pedophiles. They have been successful recently in keeping the names of the cruise lines off the arrest record. So I can't tell you which cruise lines the last several who were arrested at Port Miami worked for. Of course, I can guess, and so can you. But they need to have some kind of psychiatric vetting procedure and some kind of policy where they are permitted, just like they can inspect their cabins, to go in there and inspect their cell phones on demand, and that the crew members understand the consequences of having this stuff in their possession on their cell phones is going to result in their immediate termination, and they're going to be let off in the next country and have to find their own way home at their own expense. That's my thoughts. Let me know what you all think. And for more information from a lawyer who sues cruise lines for a living, my name's Spencer Ehrenfeld. I'm the cruise ship lawyer. And as always, have a safe cruise.